Welcome to the first Saab TransponderTech webinar. Today's broadcast will cover recent development and future in the shipping domain. I'm Tobias Tevel, sales responsible at Saab TransponderTech. And by my side, I have Mr. Peter Berjung, head of product strategy and portfolio. Peter will guide us through our achievements so far. Peter, welcome.
Thank you.
Today we talk about VDES and why Saab is taking lead in this field. Peter, why VDES?
VDES is the next generation of ordinary AIS. Excessive load on the AIS channels paved the way for VDES. One commonly known benefit is that VDES will offload the currently overloaded AIS channels.
And how about user benefits? What's in it for the shippers and the ship owners?
VDES will be a cost-effective solution for global connectivity for the ship's bridge officer of the watch, who can be in contact with the shore or a ship in another continent if necessary. VDES will be a central part of a future e-navigation technology, leading to safer and greener shipping.
Okay, new features and applications. Now let's look at 1 minute video about VDES, the next generation of AIS. VAR 60 VDES base station is already in serial production. What can you tell us about this capability and the future roadmap once VDES becomes mandatory?
VDES is backward compatible with the AIS and gives global connectivity, higher bandwidth and high cybersecurity. Antennas and interfaces can be reused from existing AIS installations. Saab's VDES transponders are form, fit and function, which gives very high cost efficiency. Saab, Orbcomm and OASI Clyde Space will send up a demo with the satellite. Global connectivity and routing is the goal.
Interesting. And what about the shipborne transponders?
Certainly. Shipborne transponders are currently in development. And this is the first R6 circuit board, currently undergoing extensive testing and verification procedures. We will conduct live shipborne trials in the spring 2021, and type testing will start in the autumn 2021.
Okay, very interesting. And when will it become available on the market?
January 2022 is the planned market introduction, and what we at Saab call product general availability.
Great news indeed. My final question. How would you consider the success with AIS has enabled Saab to be leading in the VDES development? What does this mean?
Saab were pioneers in AIS and had the first type-approved AIS product in the world. This was in May 2002. So we have a strong heritage to maintain.
Thank you, Peter. This was the first webinar from Saab TransponderTech, and we will definitely follow up this interesting plan along with the VDES development. We hope you have enjoyed the recent highlight from us, and you're most welcome to send us your feedback or topics that you would like us to bring up next time. Thank you for watching. We'll see you soon again. Goodbye.
Goodbye.